again, those are the I call them, those are the crazy times for Anthrax, because we were a little lost about what, it was a weird scene. It was a weird scene, what was going on then, you know, what was going on in those, that, in music, in metal. So,
what do you mean?
Pantera was it. They were carrying the flag of metal, let's face it, in those days, Pantera. And we were friends with them. They were, you know, longtime friends and just great people. And they asked us to come on tour. And to be really honest, that was the scariest tour I've ever had, because I remember, I love these guys, but drinking, we were never big drinkers, Anthrax.
You guys were sober people.
Not
you guys
even
were
sober, like we just never had that. We never drank until that tour. Dimebag literally taught me how to drink whiskey. Rest his soul, and I love this man like no other man. That was an angel on the earth. And a lot of people say how great he was. That was an angel. I believe his talent was, again, we're going deep with the sea of music.
Mm-hmm.
That guy, he had so much more to give. And that's why I'm just sorry that's not still here.
Yeah,
rest in peace. But Dimebag became the sixth member of Anthrax just because it was so close. And I remember Charlie was very close with Dime. They would talk all the time. And Charlie said, and he just brought up to him, hey, would you play in one of the songs? Just send it over. Literally sent it over, done. And then a couple of records on, it was just like, what would you want to do this? I need a new TV. So we bought him this huge TV and he played on the record. You know, it'd just be one of those great things.
I love deals like that.
It was all one of those great, but he'd come back. Let me tell you something. Those songs would come back and your mouth would be on the floor with that lead. It's like, what the hell was that? Where did that come from?
Did he get writing credit?
I don't think he could have. I don't care. I would give it to him. It doesn't matter. I don't think he wanted. I don't think he doesn't want to be bothered with that, because he just wants it for the love. Dime was about love. Dime was about love. Talk about music love. Mm-hmm. That man, rest his soul, was all about the music.
Mm.
All about the music. It was love. And talk about diehard Kiss fans, man. He was the ultimate.
Right.
Him and Vinny, I have to say, those brothers, they are sorely missed in music in general. Not just metal, just music. And on the earth as people. They were great people. I don't know if you ever met them before.
Never did.
Dude, they're just the best vibe.
Uh-huh.
I mean, we've gotten in a lot of trouble around the world, drinking and stuff like that.
Yeah.
But those are the best times.
Yeah.
Those are the best times. Fun, great living times. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
Those are really living. Yeah, that got us there. I remember one time we were in a casino. Anthrax would tour with the Pantera. Am I telling too many stories?
No.
Oh, bro, this is great. Are you kidding? You're kidding.
I didn't even get to Axel yet.
It's a lot of good ones. So we're on tour with Pantera, and this was the protocol pretty much every night. We go there. Anthrax play the show. Dimebag would come on the stage with a tray full of Black Tooths, which would be Crown Royal and Coca-Cola.
Mm-hmm.
So shots, right? So he'd stop our show. We'd have to do it. And this is before the night started, before the Pantera show or anything. So we'd be good there, right? So then we watch the show and drink during the Pantera show. After the Pantera show, go back. They had these cases loads of Taco Bell everywhere. Taco Bell everywhere. Amazing. It's just everybody in
they
the arena
Taco
felt like,
Bell.
Dude. And so it was great. It was a great diet of whiskey and Taco Bell. This was every night.
Yeah.
So after the Taco Bell, everybody's buzzed. Dime would say, let's go to a casino. Dude, the local casino, they had it picked out already. I swear to God, man, it's almost every night. So we'd be loaded going in. We were loaded. Bad. I mean, we're all farting, everything, because Taco Bell is just disgusting
drunk,
in every way.
Farting.
So we smell like motherfuckers. Right? It just smells disgusting. So there's booze and shit everywhere, right? So we get to the casino, and we're taking over like blackjack tables and stuff, all of us together. You know, they're serving us nonstop. We're betting so heavily on these stupid, I mean, there are stacks of money being bet. Ridiculous, right?
Mm-hmm.
Liquor. What happens is the bosses come up. What do you call the pit bosses?
Yeah.
Can I help you with anything, sir? Diamond goes, yo, get me some McDonald's. The dude had McDonald's delivered to our table, and we were eating McDonald's playing blackjack at this casino. I'll never forget that. And then when Dimebag lost all this money, they had to carry. I remember this one specific time they had to carry him out. He goes, oh, you're done, took all my money, now you want me to leave? I remember they were carrying him out because he had to leave. People wanted the table. So it was one of my favorite times. Good times in Pantera.
That's amazing.
Great souls.
What casino was that?
Midwest. There's a lot of Midwest casinos that you don't know about.
Yeah.
Oof, good times.
Yeah,
man.
When I went back to Ohio, they all of a sudden in Cleveland, they had casinos and
dude,
shit like
this
that.
This casino's everywhere now.
It's like, what the fuck?
Totally dangerous. And then, you know, then you get back on the bus after the casino, And you wake up the next morning, the parking lot of the next show, and I'd be in the well, you know, the bus on the floor, in the well, and just everything all over, you got Taco Bell, everything all over your mouth. Oh, and it was just, you have to get up for the next day.
Yeah,
and
but that, how do you deal with it the next day? It was pain.
It was pain. I have to be really honest, that was the scariest tour. So when I came home off that tour, I was gray. Gray, I look gray. My wife, and she looked at me and goes, oh, no. She was not having it. So I literally just cut it right there. And I mean, I'm not sober, but I had to cut just drinking for like a couple of months after that.
Yeah.
It was rough. I'm not prepared for that. Those guys are pros with that.